Okay, for this video, I'll be discussing direct and circumstantial evidence and also include in this video positive and negative evidence. So let us start with the differences between direct and circumstantial evidence. So ano bang ibig sabihin ng direct evidence? It is which proves the fact in dispute without aid of any inference or presumption. So the key word here is this, without aid of any inference or presumption. Hindi mo na kailang i-presume. Okay? Without aid of any inference or presumption, hindi mo na kailang i-presume kasi klarong-klaro, kitang-kita. Okay? Evidence which is believed proves existence of facts issue without inference. So, the keyword is still, no? Without inference or presumption. Again, hindi mo na kailang i-presume kasi klarong-klaro, kitang-kita. Example, nakita ng isang eyewitness kung paano pinatay ni ACB. Kitang-kita niya, no? Paano pinatay ni ACB? That is direct evidence. Or nakita sa CCTV kung paano binaril ni ACB. That is direct evidence. Kasi doon, hindi mo na kailangan i-presume. Kasi klarong-klaro, kitang-kita. Okay? Yung circumstantial evidence naman is a proof of facts taken collectively, pwede mo pag-isa-isayin yan, anyway, the existence of particular fact in dispute may be inferred, yung say, pwede mong i-presume as necessary or probable consequences. As necessary or probable consequences. So, example, i-presume mo lang siya yung gumawa kasi meron ka nakita or merong evidence. Okay, for example, ito, nakita ng isang witness na lumabas yung suspect sa bahay. Okay, pero hindi niya nakita kung paano pinatay yung biktima sa loob ng bahay. Ang nakita lang niya, lumabas yung suspect. So that is only circumstantial, no? Circumstantial lang 'yan. Or ang ibang tawag sa circumstantial is indirect evidence. Indirect evidence. Kasi hindi niya kita, hindi niya nakita kung ano nangyari talaga. Nakita lang niya is lumabas sa bahay. Or sa CCTV. Nahagip sa CCTV yung pagtakbo ng suspect. Pero hindi nakita doon kung paano binaril ng suspect yung biktima. Ang nakita lang doon sa CCTV, ito matakbo na yung suspect. Is that direct evidence or circumstantial evidence? That is circumstantial. Kasi inference lang yun. Anong inference? Presumption lang yun. Siya yung nag-commit kasi tumakbo siya. Okay, tumakbo siya. So that is the difference between direct and circumstantial evidence. Now, let's have an illustration. Ito, is this direct evidence? Actually, kung makita mo sa full video nito, ito yung nagtitinda ng pares, mami, vendor na binaril, hinold out of binaril. Okay? If you're going to look at the video, nakita talaga dito kung paano binaril nito, itong holdupper to, itong biktima, at nung matumba na, kinuha yung bag. So, is this direct evidence? The answer is yes. That's direct evidence. Okay? Kasi nakita mo paano talaga binaril ng suspect yung biktima. Let's have an example. Is this direct evidence? No? If you remember sa criminal procedure, I discussed the case of Laude and Pemberton. Again, no, Pemberton is a US serviceman, sumali sa balikatan, nag-rest and recreation, no, nag-happy-happy, pumunta sa bar, nagkita sila ni Laude, they decided to make out, nag-check-in sa isang hotel, sa isang, I think, pension house yun. Then doon, sabi ni Pemberton, charing, nailed ko sa buing, kasi lalaki pala yun, okay, kala niya babae. And because of that, pinatay ni Pemberton si Laude. Nilublob doon sa inodoro at napatay si Laude. Ngayon, meron bang direct evidence? Meron bang talagang nakita kung paano pinatay ni Pemberton si Laude? Actually, wala. Walang direct evidence. Pero, meron mga circumstantial evidence. Ano mga circumstantial evidence yun? Mga presumption. Una, itong CCTV footage nito. Ito si Pemberton, ito si Laude, nakita silang sumabay ng lumabas sa isang bar. Nakunan sa CCTV na magkasamang lumabas sa bar. But if you're going to look at this alone, can this prove guilt beyond a reasonable doubt? No, hindi. Okay? Yan nakita lang naman dyan yung lumabas niya sa bar. Hindi nakita yung pagpatay. Another CCTV, nakita yung dalawa masaya, magkasama, pumasok sa isang attention house sa Olongapo City. Okay? Is this enough to prove guilt beyond a reasonable doubt? Again, no. Is this direct evidence? No. Happy-happy pa sila dyan. Hindi nakita dyan yung pagpatay. Tapos yung front desk nag-testify. Sabi niya, yung dalawa yung magkasama yan. Yung room boy nag-testify, silang dalawa ang nasa room. Then, napatay si Laude. Now, ang tanong, meron mang direct evidence? Wala. Pero, pwede ka bang makondikto using circumstantial evidence or indirect evidence? Actually, yes. Kung merong maraming circumstances at pag i-connect mo yun, it will create guilt beyond reasonable doubt. So ito, this is one circumstance, this is another circumstance, circumstantial evidence, then yung testimony ng Vandis, another circumstantial evidence, yung testimony ng Romo, another circumstantial evidence, pag pinatanggol mo yan, then Pemberton was found guilty of homicide beyond reasonable doubt. So again, no, very crucial yung circumstance. Kasi pag direct evidence, eh, klarong-klaro, kitang-kita eh. Convicted ka talaga dyan. Sa circumstantial, can you convict a person using circumstantial evidence? Actually, the answer is yes. Is yes. No? In criminal cases, circumstantial evidence is sufficient for conviction, enough to convict a person, provided, ito ang requisite. Tandaan yung requisite kasi nasa book nito, ito niya, Tony Gabab. There is more than one circumstance. Maraming circumstance. Ay, yung pinikinig ka na ito, one circumstance to, yung unang CCTV, pangalawang CCTV, testimony of witnesses, that's more than one circumstance. And the facts from which inference are derived are proven, lahat ng circumstances are proven. And the combination of all circumstances, pag pinagtapit-tapit itong lahat ng circumstances na to, is as to produce conviction beyond reasonable doubt. Kaya nga, sabi ko, yung kaso ni Laude kanina, at ni Pemberton, he was convicted for homicide kasi nga sa mga circumstantial evidence only. There was another case ito. In People versus Susan Latusa, actually, itong si Latusa, he is the wife, ang pinatay niya dito, yung husband niya, si Felix Berto Latusa. Okay? Meron bang nakita kung paano pinatay ni Susan Latusa yung husband niya, si Felix Berto Latusa? Actually, wala. Wala nakita. Okay? Pero, ito yung mga circumstantial evidence na na-proved ng prosecution. Number one, it was only the accused, the wife, and the victim who were left in alone in the house. Sila lang yung nasa bahay. Kasi yung mga anak nila, yung dalawa, inutusan ni Susan Latusa na bumili doon sa komisari o doon sa isang tindahan doon. Okay? Now, and the cause of death, that's one circumstance, sila lang dalawa sa bahay. The cause of death of Felix Berto was intracranial hemorrhage due to gunshot wound. So, gunshot wound. And Susan Latusa's paraffin test yielded positive. Si Susan Latusa nag-positive sa paraffin test. But remember, paraffin test is not conclusive. Okay? But that could be what? Circumstantial evidence yan. Circumstantial evidence yan. Okay? So, the presence of gunpowder ignited at her right hand. And the victim was right-handed. And the gun was found on Latusa's left hand. Kasi gusto ni Latusa na ipalabas na yung husband niya nagpakamatay. So, nung nakabulagtan na yung husband, nilagay ni Susan Latusa yung firearm sa left hand ng asawa. Doon yun yung mali niya. Kasi right-handed yung husband niya, bakit yung gun na sa left hand? So, imposible yun. No? Kung magpapakamatay ka, you will use your strong hand. So, yan. That's one. That's another circumstance. No? And Sasimi Latusa, actually, ito yung anak, testified, she heard Colonel Santa Ines. Colonel Santa Ines is the, ito yung paramour, no, ni Susan Latusa. Tell her, mother, bakit mo inamin? Sana pinawak mo kay Major yung baril, saka mo pinotok. So, yun yung narinig ni Sasimi Latusa, yung anak no, ni Susan Latusa. And the children testified, they were informed by the victim regarding threat of Santa Ines to the whole family. So, yung father nila, sinabi niyo mga anak na may threat sila galing kay Santa Ines. So, taking all these circumstances, Susan Latusa was convicted for parricide beyond reasonable doubt. Okay? So, again, no? Direct and circumstantial evidence. Direct evidence is the process, the fact in issue without, so, ang keyword again is without inference or presumption. Hindi mo na kailangan i-presume. Kasi klaro-klaro, kitang-kita. So, circumstantial evidence is proof, fact, or facts from which, taken singly or collectively, the existing particular fact may be inferred. May be inferred means may be presumed as necessary or probable consequences. Okay, tingnan nyo. What is the direct evidence of the gender? Ito ba ay lalaki? Ito ba ay mga babae? Di ba? You know, looks now are deceiving. No? Paano mo malaman ang isang tao ay lalaki o babae? Okay? I mean, again, looks are deceiving. Ito, isang grupo ng babaeng gustong maging lalaki lumantad. So, ito yung mga trans man. Ito naman, mga trans woman. Dating babae na gustong maging lalaki. Dating lalaki na gustong maging babae. Okay, so again, looks are deceiving. Hindi siya batayan sa gender ng tao ngayon, no? In this age. Okay? Pero what is the direct evidence for para makita, para malaman na yung gender nila? Well, sabi niyo sir, tinatin yung sex organ. Pwede rin, pero enough na yung makita yung birth certificate. Okay? Pag makita yung birth certificate, kasi nakalagay naman dun na male or female, although may mga pagkakamali nagkakamali. Pero again, the birth certificate is still direct evidence of the gender of a person. O ito na nyo, yan. Isang malaking babala. Hindi lahat ng sexy ay babae. So ano to? Babae, lalaki. So ito, klarong-klaro, kitang-kita. No? Klarong-klaro, kitang-kita, lalaki talaga daw. Okay? Yan yung direct evidence. Now, let us discuss positive and negative evidence. Ano ba yung positive at negative evidence? Testimony is positive, positive evidence yan, when the witness affirms, the keyword here is affirms, affirm, affirmative, that the fact did or did not exist and entitled to greater weight. Mas mabigat ang positive evidence. Negative evidence is when he says that he did not see, hindi niya nakita, or did not know the actual occurrence. And it's considered to be the weak defense, very weak defense. So actually, pag sinabi ng eyewitness, oh, kita ko yan, siya yung pumatay. Hindi ako pwedeng magkakamali kasi karo-karo yung mukha niya, tandang-tanda ako. That's positive. Positive identification. And it's great, entitled to greater weight. Ang negative naman, when he says that he did not see, ito yung negative niya, like alibi. Okay, sabi niya, wala ako sa lugar kung saan nangyari ang krimen. No? I was somewhere else. That's negative, and that's alibi. Okay, and it is weaker defense. Kasi nga, alibi is the weakest defense. Oh, ito yun, tingnan nyo. Ito ba na, positive. When the witness affirms, so keyword natin nito is affirm. Okay, affirm that the fact did or did not exist. Negative is witness says that he did not see or know the occurrence of fucking issue. So he did not see, that's negative. Now, ito, example. Dalawa sa tatlong suspect sa panggagahasa at pagpatay kay Andrea Espiritu, positibong kinilala ng ilang saksi. Positibong kinilala ng ilang saksi. So ano to? This is an example of positive evidence. Kasi positibong kinilala. Ang example naman ng negative evidence, itong alibi. Ano ba yung alibi? No? Ito ay depensa na ginigiit na wala ang inakusahan sa lugar na pinangyarihan ng krimen. So, he was not there when the crime took place. Wala siya doon nangyari ang krimen. That's alibi. So, but alibi is the weakest defense. No? So, ito, suspect sa karumaldumal ng krimen arestado. Sa panayam ng bumburadyo, kawayan kay Tagintin, ito yung suspect. Sinabi niya na wala umano siya sa pinangyarihan ng krimen na mangyari ang pagnanaksak kay Labog. Dahil siya ay nagtungo. So, ito yung example ng alibi. That is a negative. But remember, between positive and negative, mas mabigat ang positive identification. Okay? So, yan yung positive and negative. Now, let's go to the segment or portion where we will ask some questions. No? Applications na di-discuss ko sa inyo. So, example question, number one. Evidence of collateral facts or circumstances which an inference may be drawn as to the probability or improbability of facts in dispute. So there is an inference may be drawn as to probability and improbability. So this is what we call circumstantial evidence. Okay, indirect evidence. Okay, cumulative evidence is different kind. Okay, to cumulative, the same kind. Prima facie is standing alone or sufficient to provide guilt beyond reasonable doubt. So, that will be circumstantial evidence. No? Kasi, the keyword here is inference. Itong inference na to, may be drawn. Next, number two, the written record of court proceedings. A written record of court proceedings is called transcript of records. Parang PR natin yan, no? But, yun. Ano man nangyari sa court proceeding, tinatranscribe yan. Question and answer, sabi ni judge, objection, yan. Nandun yan. Deposition, ito yung testimony. In writing, this one in writing. Yung logbook, parang ano yan, parang blatter lang yan. Okay, number three. This proves the fact in issue without aid of inference. So, ito naman, without aid of inference. So, klaro-klaro, no? Without aid of inference, so that will be direct evidence. Kasi without aid of inference presumption, ito yung keyword natin dyan, no? Direct evidence yan. Okay, number four. Alden Gutierrez was charged or convicted of legal possession of firearms in an aggravated form. Okay, pag sinabi natin illegal possession of firearms in its aggravated form, actually ito yung kaso ng pagpatay. Pag pumatay, dati kasi, pag pumatay ka ng isang tao, and you use illegal, unlicensed firearm or unregistered firearm, ang tawag dun, illegal possession of firearms in aggravated form, pag nakamatay ka. So, during the hearing of several, several witnesses testified to seeing the firearm in possession of Alden. So, maraming witness nag-testify na sa kanya, si Alden may dala lang firearms. He contended that the existence of firearm was not sufficiently proven because the prosecution had not presented the firearm. Yun nga lang, ang problema, hindi na-present yung firearm during trial. Pero maraming witness ang nag-testify. Is Alden correct? Tama ba si Alden na kailangan present yung firearm? But remember, the case is killing, ha? Hindi yung illegal possession of firearms per se. No, it's killing. Aggravated form kasi ito. So, hey, tama ba si Alden? No, hindi tama si Alden because testimonies of witness taking together sufficiently established existence of subject firearms and the fact that Alden possessed and used said firearm in firing the victim. So, again, ang ano ito is circumstantial evidence from witnesses. Kasi maraming testify. All pointed to Alden. Sabi naman ng B, yes, tama si Alden. It is necessary daw na i-present yung firearm because it is corpus delicti. Okay? Corpus delicti ba yung firearm sa kaso ng pagpatay? Actually, hindi. It's not. See, the fact that several shots were heard is sufficient to establish existence of firearm. Hindi tama si Alden kasi narinig yung shots. Is it enough? Marinig yung shots? Hindi. Kailangan nakita kung paano binaril. Yes, tama si Alden because between real and testimonial evidence, the former means real prevails over the latter. Mas mabigat na yung real evidence which is the firearms compared to testimonial of the witness. But in this case, in this scenario, kasi pagpatay ang kaso dito, aggravated form to, the answer is letter A. Mali si Alden. Because testimony of witnesses, although it could be circumstantial, but if you're going to take it collectively, taking together sufficient established existence of subject firearm. Okay? So yan yung circumstantial evidence rule. If the suspect defense is he is not in the place when the crime took place. Wala siya sa lugar ng saan nangyari ang krimen. Anong klaseng evidence yan? What kind of evidence is it? It's negative evidence. Okay, negative evidence yan. Number six, a CCTV footage which clearly showed how the crime took place is a pag clearly showed, nakita talaga doon paano pinatay ni ACB, that could be direct evidence. Okay, so clearly showed eh. So yan. And it is CCTV footage. An eyewitness clearly identified the perpetrator of the crime. The testimony of witness is, ito, eyewitness clearly identified the perpetrator. Ano yan? Pag clearly identify ng eyewitness, that is what you call positive. Kasi again, clearly identified by the witness, by the eyewitness. Okay? So, I think that's the last part of my discussion on direct and circumstantial evidence.